country has been failing. In many places around this country, children are not receiving the education that they deserve, and we've spent so much money trying to improve upon the system. But now we have reached the point where there is nothing else that we can do to improve. With increasing inflation and threats to our economy, ladies and gentlemen, we have to begin cutting back, and what better controversial place is there to start than education? Now, the past 6 years we've employed the use of virtual simulators to give those who are terminally ill the experience of a lifetime of love and satisfaction.
I ask, wouldn't that same technology be useful in that of educating people? A platform which simulates a world up to the highest level of realism, taking on years of education. I say, if a terminally ill patient can live out an entire life within the course of 2 days, wouldn't it also be possible for our children to experience a full education in the course of a few hours?
Come on.
Mr. Hemsworth, sir, how are you doing?
Good. You? With this new simulation, we can go through 3 years of education in 3 hours. It'll save us millions of dollars.
Are you sure we're even ready to use this kind of technology? I mean, like, the last time we tried this, they were on terminally ill patients. I mean, how would a person feel to be a machine for 3 years? So when is this technology going to get ready for public use?
We're still taking a while. We're imaging everything to give it as a realistic experience as possible.
See, and can't you guys just release it any sooner? I mean, like, that tutorial session was pretty good.
We're trying to make it as realistic as possible, and we're getting every detail from the imaging sequence. We have our technicians working to capture every detail in the school to make it as realistic as possible. Our system is completely safe to use. All people inside will be required to carry one of these. This is an outlet reader. In case of a disaster, it'll help people in shutting down the system.
So, for an important device, why is it so small?
It's highly unlikely that a situation for it would even arise, so we didn't spend much time in the creation of it.
Okay.
This room is pretty much our control room. In all of these computers, you can use the same functions as an outlet reader. This room in general is the film room and is where we store most of our software.
All right, so what do I do?
You will be an intern of sorts. We're gathering young high school students interested in the virtual reality systems. Before we can release it to the public, we have to test it out.
All right, so am I going to be testing it out?
No, you'll go into the system in case something does happen, but it is highly unlikely.
And say if it does.
Like I said, highly unlikely.
All right. So who's testing out the system?
A small group of high school students whose parents have agreed to let them are going to be testing it. They're going to be in the system for 3 years, or 3 hours will pass in the real world. This will prove that it is safe to use, and that this is the future of education.
All right. Let's say if it doesn't work.
It will. No one is going to opt out of this program.
All right, well, this is the end of the road.
Okay, well, I'll see you later. I'll be with Mr. Hemsworthy.
All right. You be good with us.
Okay, well, maybe afterwards we can go and get some lunch.
Okay, then. Have a fun time.
Okay, well, just don't go getting in big trouble, brother.
You know me. I'm a resourceful man when I'm cautious.
Yeah, that saying just isn't cool, Grant.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's just too cheesy.
How about you tell me a better one?
Fine. See you later, alligator. Yeah.
Really? That one doesn't seem to make sense.
Alright, well, I gotta go, bro.
Alright, see ya.
Okay, bye, Grant.
Yes, sir.
This message is to Mr. Grant McCoy, the brother of the former Valerie McCoy. Nothing can be said to ease your pain in this time, and I want to express my sincerest condolences. My office is open anytime to you and your family. If you need anything, let me know. We're dedicating our work here at Volcano Vista to your sister, Valerie McCoy. I know this is a hard time for you, but I'd like to offer you a position as security coordinator for the programs we are creating. After working with your sister for the past year, I feel a strong responsibility to what has happened to her and the loss your family feels. I want to make sure you and your family are taken care of. Just give me a call or stop by my office if you're interested in the job. Your sister would want you to have it. Just think about it, Mr. McCoy. Get back to me if you're interested.
Hey guys, I'm just checking in. I wanted you all to know that today marks the third year that I've been stranded in this godforsaken program. I only hope you guys are doing okay, and I just wanted to give you an update on what's been happening. So I've got about 4 months of food left stocked up, and as you guys know, I don't have a system outlet reader with me, so I can't restart the program and get the much desired food supplies, or shut off the system for that matter. It's a real shame. Anyway, I will continue to try and get into the system and adjust the settings, and meanwhile, you guys just hang in there. I'm not sure if you can hear me, but if you can, just know that I think I'm getting real close to a solution, and that you're not on your own, and I'm here for you. This is John Decker, signing off. That Mr. Hensworthy guy assured us this program was going to be as realistic and safe as possible. I've got two system outlet cables left, so that means I got two more attempts at trying to get us out of here. I just wish I had a system outlet reader. This would be so much easier, but you know, as well as I do, the system is flawed and broken. Nothing worked properly at the beginning, and everything continues to be broken. I'll just see what happens from here. I'm going to attempt this reset, and hopefully we'll be out of here.
Can anyone hear me? Please respond.
Respond, please. This is John Decker, please. Is anybody there?
I know you people listening. I know you're there. Please respond to me. Why the hell aren't you responding?
I'm right here. Just give me a sign.
Hello? Is anybody there?
People been.
Look, Mr. Decker, it's okay. We're here to help.
I've been here for 3 years. The system is broken.
It's okay, Mr. Decker. We're gonna try and shut down the system, and you can brief us all about
it. I've tried to shut it down. It doesn't work.
We know. We've tried to fix the problem, and we're gonna try and reset the system soon.
I believe the others are trapped in another portion of the system.
Again, it's going to be okay, Mr. Decker. We're going to take care of everything from right here.
There's a no sign of system outlet switch over here.
There's one down in the computer lab in the G hall.
Really? Is that so? All right. I want to start sweeping upstairs, and then we'll do the downstairs.
I don't know, Grant. Maybe we should check it out.
Nah. Last time we listened to a volunteer, we wasted too much time. Sorry for late.
Hey, asshole, I've been stuck in here for over 3 years. You morons put this into a faulty program. I'm telling you, the system outlet reader's in G-Hall.
Cry out loud. Okay, fine. I'm headed to G-Hall. It's dark in here. Jim, turn on some lights.
Of course.
How did you do that?
Whatever. It's just my computer.
Where'd you get it?
You mean you never got one?
No, I never did.
Okay. Before we do anything, I think we need to figure out what actually happened here.
You see, the system was broken when we first got here, and we've been running into problems ever since.
Problems? All right, let's just get this over with. We can tell stories when we're out of here.
Yeah.
Hey, Jen, can you shut it down from here?
I can't shut it down from here.
Called it. Guy's lunatic.
Hold on a second. We can't go pointing fingers yet because we don't have all the information. Jim, help me out with this.
Well, it looks like the system worked at one point, but it's screwed up now.
What do you mean screwed up?
Well, can we fix it?
Told you the system was broken.
What is that supposed to mean? Are we stuck here?
No. It just means we have to find another computer that actually works. But I did find some strange reading inside of the J-Hall.
Hey, we can't go into the J-Hall.
Please enlighten us. Why can't we go to the J-Hall?
There's something there that killed our entire group, okay?
I'd love to hear this story. Please continue.
Look, we went to the J-Hall area and we trapped something in there, okay? All I know is I made it alive, alright?
Okay, you know what? This isn't interesting anymore. Okay, Jim, Hannah, Farley, we're going to the J-Hall.
Look, I told you can't go in there. There's still something in there, alright?
No, you told me a bullshit story.
Grant, maybe we should listen to him. It's not smart for us to just run in there blindly.
Oh, of course, listen to the lunatic.
Okay, that's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying that we should check out all of our options before we go and do something stupid.
What options are there?
Information? What if there is something in there?
There's nothing in there.
What do you mean?
You don't know what it is?
I don't know what the heck.
I don't know. I just want to go shut it off, get my paycheck, and go home, okay?
That's what we're all trying to do, but if there's something in there, none of us are going
to
make it home.
Look, we wasted enough time listening to this guy, okay?
I can't. He's our survivor. We might have to give him an option to talk.
Oh, survivor. Okay, so then that just makes him the expert in this entire damn thing.
Well, he's been here for 3 years longer than any of us.
The guy is obviously delusional.
What do you... Okay, definitely define delusional. He's been here for 3 years.
Hey, guys. I can just use my system outlet reader and get rid of whatever it is.
Would that work?
All right. Let's give it a try.
Yeah. Sounds too risky. I think we should just go for it. I guess. It's worth a shot. You have to be careful, though.
Sounds like a plan. Keep in contact.
And please be careful.
It'll be fine.
Hopefully. Good luck. You really think this is a good idea, Grant?
Yeah. Nothing to worry about.
So, Jim, what are we looking for in here?
We're looking for the system out.
I know that. What does it look like?
It should look like any other ordinary outlet or a computer, but I'm not entirely sure.
Okay, you ready to go?
No, I'm not ready.
All right, Grant, we're ready.
Not left yet? What the hell? What are you waiting for? Just get in there, because I don't want to be here for
I'm getting a strange reading from inside the J-Hall. Here, listen to it. Whatever this is, it's in the J-Hall.
Are
you guys sure you
want to
go in there?
Maybe we shouldn't. You even know what it is?
No, I don't. Whatever this is, it's not even supposed to be in the simulation. Maybe that John Decker guy isn't as crazy as we thought.
Hey, Grant. Jim's worried about going inside.
You guys decide, okay? I give up.
I'm scared, guys. I don't think we should go in there.
Okay. But let's just make this quick. Okay, guys?
I don't think so.
Hannah?
This job is supposed to be simple. I'm not supposed to be putting my life in danger. My contract says so.
Hey, Grant, we've got a situation, but Hannah's having second thoughts, and it's up to her to see if we go in there.
Okay. But I'm leaving at the first sign of trouble.
Good. Can you guys stop loitering around and shut this thing off?
I have a bad feeling about this.
Really? You really had to say that?
Alright, we're through the first doors. And we're now entering the second set of doors.
The next hallway is lit up. Can you please put that away?
Oh.
I think we can find find the Alpha faster if we split up.
We shouldn't split up.
Nah, it'll be fine. Alright, I'll start from upstairs in the control room.
See, John, fine. No problem.
There's still time for them to get out. You can tell them to get out right now. Maybe they can make it out alive.
Yeah, but they're in no time.
Status?
Hold on, just give us 2 minutes.
I'm going upstairs to look for the system.
Sure.
He's being very reasonable. Those people are gonna die if we don't get them out in time.
I know. But what are we gonna do?
All we can do is talk to him.
Hey, man, we need to get those people out now.
No.
Those people matter. We need to get them out now.
Listen here, you lunatic.
Anyone there? Funny anymore. Just come out. Guys. Farley. You know, I'm just gonna leave. Guys.
Farley, where are you guys? Farley?
Please, just run.
I'm sorry.
This is bullshit! Do you understand? Everyone in Jay Hall is dead! Look, I understand you're a little pissed off, but now's not the time. We need a plan B.
Well, there's nothing we can do without Jim's system outlet leader. We need to get that pack, or we're going to be stuck in here.
Well, the system outlet reader is in J-Hall, so somebody's going to have to go get it.
How'd you do it?
Do what?
Trap that thing in J-Hall.
Thank you.
They chased us into the J Hall. And I ran out. And I shut the door.
Okay, so we find Jim's outlet reader, and we find the system outlet.
Well, is there any other way for us to get out of here without using the system outlet reader?
I've been here for 3 years without one. I'm sorry, there's just no other way.
Okay, I'll go get the system outlet reader.
Grant, I could go.
No. The mission is to save you. You were tasked with only one thing, and I fully intend on accomplishing that task.
Grant, please don't go.
Grant, I'm sorry. You don't have to do this.
I'll be my walkie-talkie. Guys, you here? Whoa! I'm getting strange readings here.
What the? I don't know.
I will not wait anymore. Maybe if I go in there, I can be with my friends, and I won't have to be alone.
If you go in there, you're going to die.
If I didn't hold out for this long, maybe the others that came with you would still be alive.
John, that wasn't your fault.
Just leave me alone.
Look, I can't let you leave. I'm sorry.
You can stare if you want, but I'm not spending one more minute without my friends.
John, seriously,
don't touch me!
John!
You can't leave me here, John!
John? John!
Yeah. Hello? Hello?
Hey guys, I'm just checking in.
Hello?
I wanted you all to know that today
Hello?
Is the third year that I've been
stranded. It's me, Grant.
In the Godforsaken program. I only hope you guys are doing okay, and I
John?
Just wanted to give you an update.
John, is that you?
So
Hello, I'm here.
About 4 months of food left stocked.
John?
And as you guys know, I don't have a system outlet reader with
John,
me.
What the hell are you doing?
I'm going to start the program and get the most desired food supplies. Or shut off the system for that matter.
John? John?
It's a real shame. Anyway, I will continue to try and get into the system and adjust the settings. And meanwhile, you guys just...
Anyone can hear this.
Malay? Malay, is that you?
Respond.
Malay, you all right?
Something. I don't want to be alone here anymore. Please, I'm so sorry for everything. Just respond.
Malay? Malay, it's okay, I'm right here. Malay? 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 Get me out of here! Help! Help!
See you later. See you later, alligator. Yeah.
We're supposed to imagine the projects.
Valerie, wait! Valerie, wait!
anyone can hear this. Please just respond. Say something. I don't want to be alone here anymore. Please, I'm so sorry for everything. Just respond. Please.
Help?
Listen, here's the system outlet reader. You gotta go and you gotta shut it down before it gets here.
Okay. Oh, come on, come on! Work!
Thank you. Thank you.